What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and today we're going to be bringing you a Madden 16 gameplay. It's actually a really interesting gameplay because we're going to be talking a little bit about Madden 17, some of my ideas for the channel going forward, and how we can prepare for Madden 17. I really like the off-season. It's actually one of my favorite times of the year because what we're able to do with this is we're able to get back in the lab and we're able to get, you know, in a practice mode and use the online experience of like head-to-head games and things like that to kind of better equip us, better prepare us for next season and some of the concepts that we're going to do. And what I want to focus on for Madden 17, it's actually something that I've focused on for actually every year, really, but especially in Madden 17 because I'm actually starting to adopt a new type of philosophy when playing Madden. And one of the things that I'm really interested in seeing how it plays out next season, this is why it's going to be one of my primary ways for playing the game, is the shotgun bunch. And the reason I'm interested in it now, I've always really been, I actually started my first ever scheme was from the West Coast playbook. And what we did there was we were able to take the West Coast bunch and was primarily the play PA post. That was in Madden 13. And I talked a ton about that play, and it was actually my base play for most of the season. And then next year in Madden 25, I believe that's right. Yeah, Madden 25. So next season in Madden 25, I was able to develop the hitch route, and that was one of my major reads going forward. And it's one of the things that I really, you know, hit hard, and I've always been able to find something good out of the bunch every single year. Last season in Madden 15, I can't quite remember exactly what I even ran, but I think it had something to do with the bunch. I'm pretty sure it did. I can't quite remember off the top of my head, but I'm almost 1,000% sure that I did run some bunch last season. Whether I did or not, it really doesn't matter. What matters is that going forward, I really want to tackle the bunch, and the main reason is because it's so... Oh, that's right. I ran the Green Bay Packers playbook last year, I believe, and that was... I ran the bunch from there, and as I get stopped here, I'm 4th and 1. But I really want to get into this bunch very, very deeply. I did a lot of content already on my YouTube channel. You can find it this season from the Kansas City playbook, the bunch there. And this year I actually ran the tight offset tight end from the St. Louis Rams book. But if you notice, when I ran that, a lot of it had to do with bunch principles because I would motion receivers over and things like that to create 3x1 sets. And that's really what a bunch set is. So that's a lot of things and kind of some background into why I want to go a little bit deeper into the bunch, because I've never really, I've always found good plays and good things about the bunch, but I've never dived in really deep in within the concept of the bunch, what it's really trying to do. And some of the things that we can really learn about it universally for Madden, not just in Madden 16 or in Madden, you know, in Madden 17 or whatever Madden, whatever the year is really irrelevant. What is relevant is the bunch formation is here to stay, and we've seen that through Madden history. It's been one of the primary formations every single year, and it's because of the way the bunch is. The nature of the formation is what makes it so good. And so with that in mind, I just wanted to kind of draw your attention. What we're going to do is we're going to do a guide on it, and it's going to be free for all of you guys. It's going to be kind of a written version of what you saw in the Mutt Free Guide series that we did on the Kansas City playbook, but we're actually going to be utilizing, I'm pretty sure right now I want to utilize the Cincinnati Bengals playbook, and I know there's a tournament player. His name his tournament name is Boogs, and I don't know if you guys are fans of This Week in Madden. If you're not, if you haven't heard of This Week in Madden, just go to YouTube, and I'll try to remember to put a link in this in the description. But from the guys at This Week in Madden, that is Z Farls and S Gibbs, and they're the guys that kind of really got me going in terms of like my passion to do things like this, to talk about Madden and to talk about it in an intellectual way. But anyway, they host a weekly show about Madden. It's called This Week in Madden, and what it really is designed to do is it's designed to kind of give you, you know, all the news about the game, but it also gives you some tips. They bring in players of all sorts of skill level, and anyway, one of the weeks I was watching, I was trying to catch up because I've been home from college trying to get ready for all my summer stuff. So I've had some time to watch some videos. And anyway, they had Boogs on the This Week in Madden show. And if you guys don't know who Boogs is, basically he competed in the Madden Challenge this season. I believe he actually did very well for himself. I can't quite remember exactly where he got to. I'm pretty sure he lost to... I want to say he lost a problem, but I'm not 100% on that. I can't quite remember. But anyway, he was in the... he was very competitive in the Madden Challenge this year. Actually, you know, did a really, really good job. And anyway, he ran the shotgun bunch almost every single play. And so he actually put out a scheme on Madden Tips, or not Madden Tips, but on Z Files on This Week in Madden, their show. He actually put out a ebook, or I don't even know if it's an ebook. I think it was just a video series, basically breaking down the bunch and, you know, kind of how he runs it. And so it's a so. But the thing I wanted to say is that he runs the Cincinnati Bengals playbook as well, and from whatever everything that I've seen, you know, he runs it in a little bit different of a way than I run it. The main reason I'm using Cincinnati playbook is for the single back bunch. Their single back bunch is very special, and the reason it's very special is because of the red zone. One of the things that I'm becoming very, 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 very fond of, and I think I put this play out from the Arizona playbook, I think in my most recent video, actually, is, and I mean, I'm looking bad right now, but it's because I'm really just experimenting with this bunch from Cincinnati. But we'll get that tightened up for you guys, and we'll get you guys out on the sticks and really doing some stuff. But one of the things I wanted to talk about is the single back bunch, and that's kind of why I chose Cincinnati, because if you actually look at Cincinnati's shotgun bunch, it's not, in my opinion, it's not that good. I would rather run Green Bay Packers. I really like the Green Bay Packers bunch. I think I did some work with that early on in the year. I know I did some work with that in Madden 15. But anyway, I really like the Green Bay Packers bunch. I also really, really like the Kansas City bunch, and I showed you guys a full scheme from Kansas City bunch, so you can find that on the channel if you want to. But anyways, so what I wanted to talk about, though, with the single back bunch, the reason the single back bunch is so important is because if you guys remember, in the beginning of the season, I was running the single back bunch ace, and I was actually running it very, very, like, pretty exclusively. Like, it was my main running set. And I really, really enjoyed it because it did a very, very good job of giving me a really, really powerful running attack while also giving me some good things that I can do passing the ball. And anyway, so the core of what I want to get at is now we're kind of mixing the two together. And I really, really, really think that it's going to be very, very powerful. It's going to be very, very difficult to stop. And so that's why we're kind of attacking the game this way now. One of the other things I wanted to talk about too is this, and you'll see that through this, through what we're getting ready to get, what's getting ready to happen at the channel, is it's going to reflect some of the things that has been going on within my development as a player. And one of the things that I'm learning, the more that I study about the game, and the more that I study not just about football in general, but really, you know, kind of broader than that even, but is this idea of simplicity. In simplicity, in the sense that, you know, we don't do a lot, but what we do better than anybody else. And that's kind of the idea for the channel going forward, is that I really want to focus on the things that I do well, and I don't want to really deal with the stuff that I don't do well. And the reason that I want to do that is because I'm not very good at explaining to you guys how to play, you know, Draft Champions, because I haven't played it very much this year. So for me to try to explain that to you, you know, it's actually going to be almost detrimental, because it's a waste. I'm wasting your time and my time, because I'm not an expert in that field. You know, what I'm really good at is I'm really good at, you know, teaching you the X's and O's of the game. I'm really good at talking about how to read the defense and things like that. I'm really, really good at that stuff. So that's where we're going to focus moving forward. And I've actually played a lot recently of, man, I am struggling. I'm struggling today. Hopefully we'll pull it together in the second half. But I've actually been playing a lot of Madden Ultimate Team recently. I played most of the year, but specifically I've been playing a lot of Salary Cap, because I wanted to kind of explore it, see what was out there. And I realized that Salary Cap, Draft Champions, all those kind of game, and even online Connected Careers mode, Madden Ultimate Team, it really doesn't matter what mode you're playing. There's some universal things that you can take from each of them, and the biggest thing for me is this idea of, you know, do what you know, kind of tailor your personnel to your scheme. And that's really the idea. You don't want to do it the other way around. You don't want to go out and the cool part about Madden, the cool part about Madden that's different than the real NFL, in my opinion, is that Madden allows you to have a scheme and then let your personnel fit your scheme. And so you can, you know, like for example, with Madden Ultimate Team, one of the ways you can do that is, for example, you know, I'll spend a lot of money on corners as opposed to on receivers, right? Because I need good corners for whatever I'm trying to do on defense, you know, or the way the game is played this year, you need really, really good zone, you know, you need really, really good zone or man corners depending on what defense you're playing. So things like that is what's going to go into the thought process here. And so, but anyways, one of the things that I think is just so essential for you guys to hear going forward from me is that same approach is going to be taken now across the board and not just in MUT, not just in ebooks, not just in whatever it may be, but what I'm really, really excited about is to apply the 80-20 principle. Tim Ferriss, I don't know if you guys are familiar with him, but he is an entrepreneur, and one of the things that he does a really good job of is he's a very good teacher and educator. He writes for, that's probably the majority of his income. He's got a couple best-selling books, one of which is called The 4-Hour Workweek. And in The 4-Hour Workweek, one of the things that he talks about is living by this 80-20 principle. And what the 80-20 principle basically means is that 80% of the things that you do really don't mean anything. You don't get a whole lot of value out of it. But there's about 20%. Within your daily agenda, within your daily routine, the 20% is where the real thing, where really the results come. And that concept really for me has played itself out in many, many ways to be true. But one of the biggest ways that it's played out to be true is in my YouTube channel. I spend a lot of time, playing the game and trying to make different types of videos. But the videos that actually bring you guys really, really strong value, they're actually, not as, that's probably one of my videos a week. And so what we're going to try to do is really focus in on the ones that really can bring you guys value and stop trying to do more than we can. And that's my goal. That's my goal for Madden 17 is to do less, but in the realm of doing less, it's actually going to equal more because it's going to be more consistency. It's going to be more depth. And I really think you guys are going to appreciate it once we get underway here. Because I'm really, really happy with where I'm kind of starting to lean towards with the YouTube channel and more specifically just my Madden game in general, how I'm going to approach teaching the game to you guys. And I think it's going to be a really, really good transition. So with that said, I want to kind of transition what we're talking about today to what we're going to be doing for the off season of Madden 17. So one of the things that I think is most important for gamers is this time of the year. I think this is where the men are separated from the boys in terms of gaming, and really, and it's not just Madden, right? This is everything. It's what you do in the off season that matters, and what it does is we're preparing you guys for Madden 17, and we're going to do everything that we can to do that. One of the ways that we're going to do that, and this is what I've done every single year, but I've not always done a very good job of it. And it's back to the basics. And back to the basics, what we're going to try to do in this series is teach you all of the basics of the game, from how to read the defense to how to user certain players and how to all of the different user skills that you're going to need to be able to compete at a high level in Madden 17. And so we're going to go through all that content for you guys over the course of the summer. I'm really, really excited about it too, because, man, I am really struggling right now with my reads, but I'm really, really excited about it because I think what it's going to do for us is it's going to allow us to kind of refresh our mind and get our minds focused on the things that are essential. And I talk about this all the time, but basically you practice and you practice your whole. All of your practice time can be summed up in a 16-minute game when you're talking about Madden specifically. And what's really interesting about that is that the idea that if you practice your whole if all of your practice time is really being built around these four 4-minute quarters, then that should change the way you're practicing, because you should be practicing with a mindset, with a mentality, with an intentionality. And that's really what we're trying to do here, is we're trying to be as intentional as we can be moving forward. And so I'm really, really excited with all of the content that I'm going to be able to bring to you guys, because I think what it's going to do is it's not only going to give you guys a lot of value, it's also going to give you guys a lot more value about how to actually get better at this game, you know, because that's the goal of this channel. The entire goal is to improve every single day on this track to try to be as good as we can at the game. And that, all of that encompasses several things, but what I think it really encompasses is intentionality. And unfortunately for you guys, I have not done a very good job in being intentional, and that's something that will definitely be changing in the coming weeks and in the coming season for Madden 17. So with all that said, guys, I want to talk a little bit now, because we talked about the Back to the Basics series. Now what I want to do is I kind of want to transition, and I want to talk about what can you do to get better for Madden 17 right now. What can you do right now to improve your game for Madden 17? Well, there's a couple things that I think are really, really important that you need to do. First and foremost, watch the great players. I think that's one of the most underrated things we do, is we may watch them, but we don't study them. So let me rephrase that: study the great players, and that is essential. That may be the most important tip that I could ever give you, is to watch and learn and study. The reason that Peyton Manning was such a good quarterback was because he studied harder than everybody else. Mentally, he had such a capacity to learn the game and such a vigor and love for the game that he put in hours and hours and hours in the film room. And it's the same principle. It's the same principle to a Madden. It's the same principle to any skill, anything that you're trying to get better at. You have to put in the time. And not only do you have to put in the time, you really have to study the people who have made it. And one of the things that I've always had ingrained within me, is this vigor for the educational aspect of things. And what it has done for me in Madden is it's really helped me develop a very strong understanding of the game. It's also really helped me understand, you know, what other people are going to do before they do it, because I've seen it. I've seen everything they're going to do. You know, I know the verticals. I know when verticals is coming. I know when, you know, curl flats or something like that's coming. I know when the corner flat straight combo, the flood concepts are coming. And what it will do, if you just study the greats, if you watch Problem, if you watch Serious Mo, if you watch Skimbo, if you watch those guys and just kind of watch how they play, what it will do for you is it will teach you so much about this game. But you have to be intentional about how you watch them. You have to study them. You can't just watch them, you know, and not actually pay attention. And I think that's where we get off a lot of times, is we'll watch these, you know, we'll watch the Madden Challenge, but all we're watching really is, you know, what actually happens on the play, but we're not watching the route combinations or the user skill or all of the things that go into making a game of Madden so fun to watch. And guys, I think that's one of the most important things that I could ever tell you, is study the greats. And, you know, that's how that is. I mean, I still have such a vigor to study the greats, and what it helps me do is it teaches me so much about the game. It, you know, because everybody plays Madden differently. You know, we all have our own personal spin that we put on this game. And I think one of the most important, obviously we should never lose that, but I think it's also very important, you know, to learn everything we can from everyone we can. And you can always learn more. There is such a wealth of information out there that can teach you and is profitable. But the only way the information actually teaches you, if you actually use it, if you actually apply it, and if you, you know, not only do you apply it and you use it, but also it's essential that you don't only take it for its word, but you apply new things to it as you're going through. And that's one of the most important things, guys, that I could ever tell you, is study, study, study. But not only study, but study with intentionality. Be intentional about how you're studying people, you know, and studying the some of the best players that play this game. Understand the concepts. If you can understand why something works, you'll understand how it can work, and not only how it can work, but how it can work from multiple formations, multiple things. Conceptual teaching will always trump systematic teaching, in my opinion. If I can teach you how to fish, you will be able to feed yourself for the rest of your life. If I can't do that, then you know you're going to struggle. So I wanted to at least make that stuff abundantly clear. The next thing I wanted to talk to you guys about in terms of how do you get better for Madden 17 is reading the defense. Guys, this is a skill that I struggle with, and I practice it. And I'm telling you guys right now, if you're not intentional about reading the defense and studying how to read defenses, you're not going to be able to do it. You're not going to be able to do it no matter how many money plays you have. If you can't read the defense, it's meaningless. And I really want to stress that, because the point for all of us is to win more games, is to be, you know, better offensively and better defensively, because if we're better offensively and defensively, we're going to win the game. And that's the goal. So don't lose sight of that. Don't get so caught up in money plays and trying to find all the hot blitzes or the hot plays that you miss, what's really important. And I missed that throw, Mariota. But what's really, really important is, you know, how do you react? Everything is reactionary in this game. It really is. When you really think about it, everything in this game is all a reaction off of what's going on. You know, how do I react to this type of thing that he's going to do? How do I react to... Oops, sorry about that, guys. My computer's going off there. But how do I react to whatever it is that's going on? That is a very important thing to consider when you're facing. And so that's why I spend so much time, you know, talking about how to read the defenses, because if you can learn how to read the defenses, then you can go to the right spot with the ball. But if you can't learn how to read the defense, you'll throw it into coverage all the time. And the thing about reading the defense is it's always something that is in progress. You're never there. You're never there when it comes to reading the defenses, because what's happening is you have to digest information so quickly, and if you're not intentional about it, it's very hard to do it. And so I just wanted to, you know, let you guys know that. That was a pretty good play by me right there. That was pretty good work. So what happened right there, and that's just something that you get with time, but basically what happened right there is I actually made a mistake in setting up my defense, because what I was trying to do, I want to explain this real quick, because it goes back to reading things and knowing when to jump, because you don't just read the defense, you also read the offense. But the cool part about what I want to say here, the reason that this is important is because what just happened right there was my defense, I was trying to run a cover two coverage on the outside, but what ended up happening was my defense, I didn't get my flat zone on that side. So I knew where my vulnerability was. I knew ultimately I'm going to be vulnerable in the flats on the left side. So my user player was the only person that could go over there to cover that zone, because nobody was in coverage there. As soon as I saw the running back, you know, running that little table route to the outside, I immediately jumped down on that flat route, and it paid off for me. He forced the throw, and we got the pick six, and that was a really big turnover for the defense right there. But it comes down to reading the defense, making good, wise decisions, knowing where you're weak. If you can know where your defense is weak, you can help it out in so many ways. As a user player, that's the key. The user player, what the user player's job is to be able to put that extra X factor on your defense. Because what a user player allows you to do is you can account for so many things that's just, you know, that are only inherent to your user player. And so, you know, on defense is just about or just as much about reading and reacting as is offense. You know, football is a game of read and react. It's so central to the game, and so I can't stress enough being able to read offenses and defenses, being able to know where they're going with the football, where your defense is weak, and how you can adjust. And guys, that is such a pivotal point to what we're doing here, and that's what we want to be about. And so we're going to teach you how to do those things in practice mode. A lot of it's hard to teach, because it you know, some of this stuff is inherent to experience. You know, some of the nuances and things like that, you can only get it with experience. But we're going to try to give you everything we can on our end to give you, you know, a decent. And that was a bad defensive play by me. But we're going to do everything we can on our end to communicate how to and why to. It's your job to go execute it. And so that's what we're trying to do here. So that's the second thing I would say is, so the first thing is study the greats. Study the problems, the Sirius Moes, the S. Gibbs and Z. Farrells and all those guys. Study the guys that have been there and done that. Learn what you can and listen to them because they have wisdom because they've got the experience. Everybody teaches from their experience, so you have to listen to the wisdom of other people. Now, the second thing that I said is learn how to read. You know, learn how to read and react, not just in the sense that I know what a cover three is, but in the sense that learn how to read where the defenders are going, and based off of where the defenders are going, where is open. That is a pivotal thing, because what's going to happen is the more you rank up the ladder in terms of Madden, the more that the better you get, the harder it becomes to read defenses, because players become experts at disguising, and that's why it's a constant developing mechanism that we have to focus on. You know, we're always in development of learning how to read the defense better. It's inherent to the game. No matter what level you are, you can always get better at reading the defense because you're reading and reacting, and it's, what you're doing is you're training your reaction time, and your reaction time can always be faster. You know, it really holds true, and it's not just in Madden. It is in life. It's in, you know, it's in football. It's in all of those things. That it's about read, react. How do I respond to situations? You know, how do I, you know, I don't want to make everything just a knee-jerk reaction. I want to make it a good, wise response. How do I do that when I only have 3 seconds to decide what I'm going to do? It takes a lot of work. It takes a lot of practice. And that's what we're trying to teach here. Is we don't want to lie to you. We don't want to tell you that, you know, we don't want to tell you it's easy, because it's not. And that's what we're focusing on here. The third thing that I would say to you, as far as how to get better for Madden 17, the third kind of aspect to that discussion, in my opinion, is learn what I think is important every year about this time, is to learn universal truths. And what I mean by that is learn universal concepts. And so what we do here, one of the big things that we'll do here is we try to teach conceptually. If you pay attention well enough, you should be able to kind of catch that conceptual spin that we're putting on things. And what is essential about, you know, understanding that conceptual spin that we're putting on everything is understand that it's not about the play, it's about why the play works. And oftentimes, if you can discover why the play works, then you can apply it to every year of Madden. That is the reason why Problem is always good. That is the reason why Sirius Mo is always good. That is the reason why Skimbo, you know, has been so competitive in past seasons. And it's not just this year, it's every year. We took a bad sack there. But, you know, I mean, guys, seriously, like, if I could stress, you know, just a little bit more on that idea, what we're trying to get you to understand why floods work. So, for example, like, on this Z spot, understand why me putting Jordy Nelson on a streak is very important to the play working, because if I'm trying to run a flood on that right side, I need him on that streak. That's a pretty good play there by T. Will. I got that campus hero, Terrence Williams, guys. You may want to check him out. He's got some really, really good stats. And I'd be interested to see if, you know, how he worked for you guys. This is the play that we, you know, picked this real playbook for, is this play corner strike. S. Gibbs was talking a little bit about it, but didn't really do a whole lot of work with it. But one of the things about it is we have that little spot route that we can high pass lead. And then you also have a corner route that you can high pass lead. High pass leading in the red zone is one of the most important things this season. And every year there's always some kind of way, you know, some kind of red zone play that you need to have, you know. But you know, that's the idea, is learn the ins and outs of the game, the way the mechanics, the way the game works, and then apply all of your conceptual stuff that you have from every year. to it. And that's what we try to do here. You know, a lot of what we really do on defense is we run three deep, three under zone blitzing schemes. It's a scheme that was really made popular by Dick LeBeau at the Pittsburgh Steelers. But one of the things is that every year we tailor it. You know, like for example, this year we're using the nickel 3-5 odd. Last year we used the nickel 3-5. I think it was just a regular nickel 3-5, and we use the same concept, which is, you know, edge pressure right, edge pressure left, but we just applied it. It was just a different formation. So every year you have, you know, different formations that have different strengths and weaknesses. But the big things to look for is that, can you run those three deep, three under zone blitzes? For us, that's one of the most critical aspects. That's one of the most critical aspects of our defense, is to be able to run three deep, three under. And then this year we discovered the concept of roll coverage, and you can find that concept in the ebook. And that should be, I don't know if that's in the description or not. If you guys want that, just let me know, because I think I took it out. Dang it. Got roasted over top again. I didn't think he'd go up top. I'm always been too aggressive. I mean, that's the second time I've gotten, you know, roasted over the top on that. So I got to be better. But anyways, guys, yeah, I just wanted to talk a little bit about that. I'll probably end up losing this game because I'm kind of running out of time here. Only got about 2 minutes left. But anyway, yeah, guys. But yeah, I mean, and I want to kind of close out, because that's kind of the main ones that I wanted to talk about. I really want to talk about a little bit more about the concept thing, because I don't know if I kind of spelled it out enough for you guys. What I'm trying to get at is this: every year there will be there's basic concepts that carry over. So for example, one of those is a flood concept. And I'll show you that right here. So we're going to have a corner, a streak, and a flat. You know, that's one of the concepts that carries over every single year to beat zone coverage, because it's a real football concept. And so what you want to do is when you're practicing, like when you're playing games, like right now, what you want to do is you want to learn how to run those concepts. Okay, so you want to be applying that corner, flat, streak. You also want to be learning how to run man-beating concepts like mesh and, you know, different things like that from the bunch. I have a lot of videos on that, and we'll be talking about those, you know, when we go forward here. But that's the idea, and that's really the most important thing you can do, especially on the offensive side, is to learn the ins and outs of all of the different concepts. Another thing that I think is really important, this is something I don't do enough, is to learn the ins and outs of playmaking. I've just recently started to practice and learn how to do playmaking, because I just have never been good at it. You know, just because I'm just not the best. I'm not the best at everything. You know, I'm not the best player, and so part of my maturity as a player is, you know, I need to learn how to. I need to learn how to playmaker and how to use it effectively. I don't want to just use it. I want to use it effectively. And, you know, that's a big deal. Dot Forte. But that's a big deal, guys. And you want to learn how to use these concepts effectively. So playmakering, learning. I would recommend going to smartfootball.com and studying some of their articles on real NFL concepts. So, for example, one of the ones that I really like is the levels concept. And that's a concept that you run from 2x2 sets. What it basically is a vertical stretch of the defense. And what that allows you to do, as we drop the pass, and he's going to close this one out for us. But what levels allows you to do is it allows you to attack the defense with what's called a vertical stretch principle. What the vertical stretch principle does is it forces the defense to defend you vertically, and so it stretches the zones. And what that means is you'll have a route that attacks the defense at 15 yards, and then you'll have one that attacks them at 10 yards, and then you'll have one that attacks them at 5 yards. And what's going to happen is you'll isolate a zone defender. And so it's a good zone beating principle. Now, think about, there's really two types of defenses. You get man or zone. Sometimes you get combo coverages where you get man and zone, but normally you get man or zone. And so, you know, you want to learn good zone beating principles. And then the other thing that you want to learn is you want to learn how to beat man with man beating principles. And we talk a lot about that. And so, for example, one of the ways to beat man with, you know, good man beating principles is to use something like a bunch. The reason we like the bunch so much is because man beating principles, you want to use kind of compressed type sets. And this guy, I don't think he ran man but just a few times today, but one of the things that we were able to do, and you know, I didn't have a very good performance today at all by any means, but one of the things that we're able to do with the bunch is we're able to run picks and rubs. And what a pick and a rub is where you run two routes off of one another, and what it's going to do is it forces the defense really to have a very difficult time when they're trying to stop you in man, because the man defenders are going to run into each other. And so you need to learn both principles, both sides of the same coin. So, but anyways, guys, that's what I've got for you today. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments. I look forward to hearing your guys' responses to this video. But hopefully, guys, I'll be able to, you know, kind of get back in the groove here and engage more with you. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments, and I'll try to make sure that I start responding and make myself as available as I can be. So I want to thank you guys. A lot of good stuff coming to our channel. And so, guys, if you like Madden, if you like football, if you want to hear more content and things like that, make sure you hit that subscribe button if you're not already, and we'll get you that content. There's a lot of things coming that you'll definitely want to be subscribed to. So we'll see you guys tomorrow with another Madden 16 video, trying to get you